Hello everyone, I am Sidhant. Today we will understand the chapter number 13. I have skipped the chapter 12, which will be taught in might be tomorrow or the day after. I have started this chapter, chapter 13, which is nothing but a balance sheet equation. It's a short and simple. Today I didn't have that much tough time, so that which I didn't have that much of time enough to taught you the chapter number 12, which has some concept, the bill of exchange. So I started this. It's very short, very simple. So let's start the chapter balance sheet equation. The balance sheet equation, we will use the acronym BSE. The balance sheet equation is nothing but a total assets is equal to the total liabilities. I already told you when we started the module B that total assets is equal to the total liabilities. That's why the name balance sheet also comes like that, because the assets always equal to the liabilities. So these assets, the total assets is equal to liabilities, and these liabilities can be splitted into capital plus total liabilities, total or other liabilities we will write. Now we will see what all are assets and what all are liabilities. So what are assets and what are liabilities? The assets are something which the company owns or have a future income of something. Future income due to something is assets. And liabilities are those things which you owe to the other people, which you have to give to the person, is the liabilities. So we will see the examples so that it will be clear to you. So what are cash? Cash is what? Assets or liabilities? Since I told you, assets are something which has its present, has some value, or in future prospect it will have some value. Since cash is the tangible one which is in our hand, which is used to buy other things, so it is an assets. Next, investment. Let's say you have invested 100 of rupees in fixed deposit. So in future it will earn you something, so this is an assets, because in future you will gain. Next, inventory. What is inventory? Assets or liabilities? As inventory is the stocks you have in order to sell it, or as a raw material, which is nothing but the tangible things in your hand. If you sell the inventory, you will get money in future, or in present also it has some values, so this is an assets. Next, your office equipments. What is this? This is also assets, because if you sell this, you will get earn money. Next, machinery. Next, your land, buildings, etc. And next, your vehicles or any machinery parts, etc. are in assets. And what all in the liabilities? Capital is the money infused by the owners, is the capital. We take it separate because of many reasons. In the liability sides, we take capital plus other liabilities. Capital is a separate because it's a money injected by the owners, and other liabilities are that loans from the banks. What I told you about the liabilities are something which you owe to the other parties. So capital, which is injected by the company owners, is nothing but a kind of liability to the company, because this money has to be given to the owners. When the, let's say when the company backups this amount, you have to give to the owners. Similarly, what are other examples in the other liabilities section? The other example, loan from the banks. This is the money you take to grow, but this money has to be given back to the person or to the bank itself when it matures, or in the form of EMI. So this is the money you owe to the bank. So this is a liability. Now we will see other examples of the liabilities. That bank debt is one of the example. Let's say you have taken some goods or raw materials on the credit basis. So in future you have to repay this money. So this will also comes in the other liabilities section. Now that's salary, or you can say the taxes which is owed, means you haven't paid but you are to give that amount. So this will come as a liabilities. For example, in the recent case of the BSNL, the employees are not paid for the last 3 months. So when they prepare the balance sheet today, they will write the salary section into the liabilities side, because this is the money they owed. And let's say your bank had paid the money on the monthly basis, so they will not write in the asset, they will not write in the liabilities, they will separately write it as an expense. It will be mentioned in the profit and loss account. So that's the difference. Now some other categories to be separated between, like that bills receivables. First we will see what are bill receivables. Let's say you as a company has supplied goods. In India scenario, how the system of business works, like you have supplied some goods, the payment will happen in 1 or 2 months of time. They will not settled at the time when the goods are supplied, or the money taken from one hand and supply the goods at the other hand, but it will take some time in India scenario. So this is the time, this is the lags in the time between the supply and the payment is characterized by the bill receivable or bills payable. So you as a company supply the goods, you made the bill. So you supplied the goods, you will receive the payment. So this, the name is bill receivables, because you have made the bill and the payment has not been done at that time. So in future you will receive the money. So that's the name is bill receivables. Now what are bills payable? You as a company purchased goods or raw materials from another company, let's ABC. So you will make payment after 1 or 2 months of time. So this case, this company will produce the bills in the name of company, and this company will pay the bill after 1 or 2 months. So this is a bills payable, and this will be in the liability side. Why? Because the company owes this money to the ABC, because they have supplied the goods, we haven't paid at that time, so we owed the money to the ABC. So this is a bills payable. So I hope you understand this. Now the next is the next tricky, I already covered. Now assets. Let's say we as a company have given some amount of loans to the other company. So what it will come? It will come in the asset side, and this is called our debtors, because someone has taken loan from us, so they are debtors to our company. And when we to take loan from other company for our enhancement, then we call the other company as creditors, and it will be in the liabilities because we owe the money. Here we give the money, so we will get something in future. It has some future values. So this is a debtors. Debtors in the assets, creditors in the liability side. Now some other examples I already told you in the previous examples as well. Let's say outstanding expenses. What do you mean by outstanding? So we were understanding outstanding expenses. What is the outstanding expenses? What does it mean? Let's say you have bought printers, but you haven't paid the money. So you owe the money. So this is nothing but an outstanding expenses. Why expenses? Because everything day to day, the cost, the day to day cost burden of the company is the expenses. So we bought the printers, we have to pay the money, but we haven't paid. So this is an outstanding expenses. In future, we owe this money, so this will come in the liabilities side. Now the next is, the bank overdraft. Let's say the bank has taken loan of 10 lakh of rupees, but they have spent all the 10 lakh of rupees and still they need some money. So they will take another 1 lakh of loan on the permission by the branch manager. So that 1 lakh of rupees is the overdraft, which is nothing, which is to be payable, which will be payable to the by the company to the bank. So this will also come in the liability side. That is the bank overdraft. So I would like to you to make one column of assets and liabilities and write all the assets and the liabilities possible, because in the exams also there is a possibility they will directly ask that to classify whether it's an asset or the liabilities. Now we will see the how the balance sheet affected because of the infusion of the money, injection of the money, expenses, cash, buying of the assets, how the balance sheet works. As I told you, the assets and the liabilities goes hand in hand. If the assets is increased, the liabilities also increased, and the vice versa. So it has a dual effect. Whenever a change in the assets, there is a change in the liabilities. Whenever there is change in the liabilities, there is a change in the assets. That's why the name is balance sheet, because we have to balance the assets and the liability sides overall. So we will see first, let's say in the first year, let's say your company got started and you put you have given 5 lakh of rupees to start the business. So this is an owner's money, which is nothing but a capital, and as I told you, when you infuse this money, this will comes as a liabilities. So how will you prepare the balance sheet? For the first year, the balance sheet is assets, liabilities. So we will short it out for the, okay, this is a balance sheet, how the balance sheet is made. So we have infused this money, this is a capital. So where we will write, we will write in the liability side that 5 lakh of rupees as capital. As I told you, it has the dual effect. Whenever there is a liability, there would be an asset. So this 5 lakh of rupees is what? This is to spend to buy machinery. This is the money to give the salaries at the starting. This is the money to buy the raw materials. So we will convert this capital. Let's say it's in the bank account, and whenever it's required, we will convert it into the cash to buy something. So we will in bits and pieces, we withdraw the money in the form of cash. So this overall is nothing but a cash. So this 5 lakh is nothing but a cash, because someday or to the other, this will be converted into the cash so that it can be spent freely to buy the raw materials, to pay salary, to pay expenses and everything. So this is the first year. This is the scenario. Now in the second year, let's say the business purchased a machinery of rupees 1000. The effect of this transaction is the amount of the cash in hand is lowered by 1000. So it means that, let's say 10,000 is spent to buy machinery for your factory. So how this will affect the assets and the liabilities? Since you have spent this 10,000 of rupees, it means that the cash will be get lowered by 10,000. So you will write 490, and in the bracket itself you will write that 5 lakh minus 10k. Here you will write the cash, this much cash remains, and I told you, and since we bought the machinery 10,000 rupees, and this machinery is nothing but a kind of assets. So we will write machinery 10,000 of rupees, okay, and the liabilities, still it's a capital of 5 lakh of rupees. So when we balance it, 5 lakh. So this is how it works. Now moving on to the next year, in the third year, let's say a goods for rupees 2000 bought by the company. Still what we have to write, since we are buying goods, so cash, we write assets, liabilities. Let's say goods or raw material, both are out and out same, 50,000 of rupees raw materials purchased. So when we buy this 50,000, what will be reduced? The cash will be reduced. Cash will become 440, and in the bracket we will show the deduction. Machinery we have of 10,000, and another raw materials. The next raw material is nothing but an asset, because it, in future if we sold, we will get some money, or it has some present value. That's why raw material is 50,000. And in the liability side, the capital remains to be 5 lakh, and total 5 lakh. Okay, now then in the next year what will happen? Let's say that now the company now what the company is doing, let's say it again bought a goods, or you can say a raw material or machinery, anything on credit. Let's say 50,000 of raw material from another company on credit. So since 50,000 on credit, now what will be the assets and liabilities of this? Since it's on credit, so this is nothing but a liability. So we had the capital of 5 lakh and the liability side. Now the extra credit 50,000. So how much is the 5 lakh 50,000? Okay, and this will be balanced by this. So what all cash we had, 440, machinery 10,000, and the raw material 50,000. This raw material is paid on the cash basis. Now this raw material or goods on credit, how much? 50,000. So this will overall become 5.50 lakh, which is nothing but equal to the assets and the liabilities. So this is how it works. Now let's say the next one, let's say now the company has produced the final goods. Now it had sell the final goods before. Let's say now the final goods are produced, and let's say we have sold the, you as a company sold the goods on credit. You are selling the goods on credit, so worth of 50,000 of rupees. So this will comes on the asset or the liability side, since we are giving on credit. So future mein paisa aana hoga, since it's had future value, so it will be an asset. So we will write it in the asset side. Now here, before making the assets and the liabilities, we will understand something. Since we sold the goods on the price of 50,000 of rupees, but the cost really existed will be less than this, because the business is like this, that you bought something for rupees 2 and you add some margin, let's say 2, and you sold it for rupees 4, so you get a profit of rupees 2. So we are selling it for 30,000, and let's say the real cost of goods, let's say the everything can be taken into concern, like the electricity bill, the wages, the payment to the persons, and the real cost on the raw materials, everything is taken into concern. Let's say the real cost applied by the company is 30,000, but he sold it on the 50,000, so the profit is of rupees 20,000. So where this 20,000 will go? It will go directly into the reserves or surplus. Okay, this you should keep it into your mind. Now how the assets and liabilities will look, and we throughout every examples we have seen that for every transaction there is a dual effect, means if the assets got changed, the liabilities also got changed. So how will we write? First we will write all the assets of the previous years, and also one thing that we have taken into concern, as it's year to year change, but the everything is taken into concern, because it's first that business is a going concern, runs on the concept of the going concern entity, so it will goes on. And as I told you that for the balance sheet and P&L account, means profit and loss account, what does this shows? The balance sheet shows the position of the company, and P&L shows the performance of the company. What does it mean? Since this one is balance sheet, we have taken that we write from the first year whatever mentioned in the after the 5 year, the same thing is mentioned there. So the position covers all the entire time period the company runs. The balance sheet covers all. We have also seen that. But in the profit and loss account, so everything is taken into concern, because the first year this is the condition, the second year this is the condition, after third year this is the condition. So in every year we have taken everything into concern. So balance sheet gives the position of the businesses throughout the year, but profit and loss account will only give the performance of the last year. Profit and loss account will give the picture only the transactions or the expense or the income of the last year only. So it will give the performance of the company or the for the particular year. So how the assets and liabilities, coming to the fifth thing, is the what are the assets and liability scenario. We will write all the things which already mentioned, that 440 is the cash with us, machinery 10,000, raw material 50,000, and raw material on credit 50,000. Okay, now the new thing which will be added here, so the new thing what will be added here is that, yes, debtors. Why debtors? Because we have given so goods on the credit basis. So we are giving the goods on credit basis. It means that future mein paisa aana hoga. So this one is an asset. Debtors are our assets. So how much money will come? That is 50,000. Because we have sold the goods of 50,000. But here one thing is taken into concern. Since we sold the goods of worth of rupees 50,000, but what all cost applied to us? The real cost applied to us is 30,000, which will be reduced from the raw material itself. So we have to reduce this 30,000 from the raw materials. So we have reduced 30,000 raw materials in the bracket, and you will write that 20,000 is remained here. And how the liabilities changed? Since capital remains the same, 5 lakh. Credit, creditor, since we have taken raw material from one of the raw material is through the credit, 50,000. And next, reserves and the surplus. Reserves and the surplus of rupees 20,000. So this comes 5,70,000 of rupees in the liability side. Similarly, the asset side also, if you calculate, it will come the same. Now, one thing is you can ask that why the reserves and the surplus are taken into liability side. As I told you, the capital, why capital has is being mentioned in the liability side. So similar, the whatever the profit the company earns is nothing but belongs to the owner. It will be taken by the owner at some point of time. So this money is also the company owes to the to its owner. So that's why it's in the liability side, the reserves and the surplus 20,000, and the in the liabilities sides. So one concept we will learn here, because here our net worth increased in it. So what is net worth? We will understand. Net worth is nothing but an total assets minus total liabilities. So what are net worth? The total assets minus total liabilities. Here the total liabilities means after the we have to take every all the liabilities except the capital and reserves. So we have to remove the capital and the reserves. The total assets, whatever the total assets, if you see the 5th year's example, what we had in the total assets, 570 lakh. So here the total assets is 5.70 lakhs, and the total liabilities except capital and the reserves, what is there? We will have to remove capital and the reserves, 520 we have to remove. So 50,000 is the amount. So if we subtract 50,000 from it, so 5.20 lakh is our net worth. You got it? So this is our net worth. Now this is it, I think. Yes, this is completed. So this is how the every year the balance sheets got changed. It's balance sheet is nothing but a snapshot after the after every year. The snapshots of all the assets and the liabilities of the company has is the balance sheet. So this is the things, and you we have taken understand what is the net worth, the total assets minus total liabilities, and the total liabilities we do not count the capitals and the reserves, because this is taken separately. Instead of writing total liabilities, we can write other liabilities, that will be more suitable. So this is it with the chapter. Now we will discuss the other chapter in the next class. So thank you. One important appeal I want to make to the people, after the watching of the videos, you should at least practice 5 to 10 questions from the from any sources, either the question bank or the online sources, so that you you will be cleared with the concepts, and you can easily play with the concepts at the time of exams. So that's it. Thank you.